Amen. Hello, good afternoon, good morning. Welcome to my moment of encouragement. God bless you. Happy Easter. Today is Easter Sunday. Glory be to God. May the joy of the resurrection of Jesus Christ abide with you and your households in the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to encourage you today from the book of Hebrews chapter 11, verse 11. I read it in the Living Bible, and it just came at me that we are a group of people that have hope even in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Hebrews 11, verse 11, the Living Bible, it says Sarah too had faith, and because of this, she was able to become a mother in spite of her old age, for she realized that God, who gave her his promise, would certainly do what he said. And I was so encouraged by it, and I know that it would encourage you. You see, the Bible says that Sarah had faith and became, and because of this, she was able. So the faith of Sarah gave her the ability. I went and looked at the word able. Able means empowered. So faith is an empowerer. Hallelujah. It gave her the power to become. So faith gives us the power. It gives us the ability to become. Hallelujah. I was so encouraged looking at this, that despite the fact that Sarah was barren, it wasn't as if that Sarah had, you know, she was okay, maybe she had a child and that child died, or you know, she had been pregnant before and she had a miscarriage. No, she was barren, but despite that, she had enough faith. The faith that she had brought her to the point of ability to become a mother. She became a mother in spite of her age. Not only in spite of her age, in spite of the fact that she was barren. So in spite of the fact that she was old, she realized. So you must come to the realization. You must come to a point where you realize that God is able to give us a promise and is able to certainly do what he has said. Hallelujah. The promise that God gave to Sarah was a promise that she will become a mother, that she will become the exalted mother. That was the promise. God changed her name from Sarai, a princess, to Sarah, the mother of nations, an exalted mother. That was the only promise she had. Remember that, you know, she did not know a lot about God. She came from a family that worshipped idols. She knew, all she knew about God, maybe peradventure she knew anything about God, was that he was the creator of heaven and earth. And Adam messed even that up. So there was not a good testimony to hear from Adam. I think the only testimony that she could hear, maybe two. One was the one about Enoch that lived with God and he was righteous and he was taken. That was written down for her. Also about Noah. About Noah. Those were the only testimonies that she could hear, that she knew. But God, she stood in what God, the word that God gave to her. And I want to encourage you. We have so many testimonies of what God has done. At least Sarah was one of them. Noah was another one. And if we go down the line, we know the testimony of Isaac when his wife was barren. The Bible said that he prayed for Rebecca, and Rebecca had children. Isaac in the book of Genesis was able to build wells, and he was able to sow in a land where there was famine, and in the same year he reaped a harvest. So if we move down, we'll find out that men lived in faith. And there is record for us to look through. If we go, even in the New Testament, we have the record of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He healed the sick. He raised the dead. He opened deaf ears. He healed the leprous. Hallelujah. And then we looked at the life of Peter. We looked at the life of Paul. We see what God did through them with the power of the Holy Spirit. So there's quite a number of records that we can follow. There's quite a number of records of what God has promised for us in the scripture. And by faith,
we can receive this promise. By faith, we can know that certainly God will do what he has promised. Stepping out even of the Bible, how about the record of things that God has done even in our own time? Hallelujah. If you look at the life of Smith Wigglesworth, if you read about him, that man was able, by record, was able to raise up 18 or 19 dead people in his lifetime. This is not something that is far-fetched. This is something that happened not too long ago. How about Archbishop Idahosa in the city of Benin, raising up the dead, healing the sick? How about our fathers even at this time? Hallelujah. How about Reverend Kenneth Hagin, you know, speaking and healing people? Hallelujah. And my father in the Lord, Pastor Talabi, at this time, even in this era, raising the dead. There was a time that this man of God went into the streets of Lagos, Nigeria, and he was passing by and he saw a dead child. The family was crying, the baby was dead, and my father and the Lord went into their midst and took the baby, raised this baby up, and life came back into the baby's life. Oh, I can go on and on and on about the testimonies of what God has done by faith. You know, if you look in the book of Hebrews chapter 11, there's a hall of fame of faith people, and I'm adding to that hall of fame today. And I want to encourage you that God is still able to do, he certainly will do what he has promised. But I want your faith to rise, just like that of Sarah, that she had faith, and because of this she was able. Faith, your faith will give you the ability to become what God has called you to be. Are you in despair? Are you looking unto God for something? Hold on to his word. Hold on to those examples that I gave you from the scriptures, and even in our contemporary time. The Lord bless you. You will carry your own child. You will be healed. You are healed in the name of Jesus. You will have your own papers to live in the country that God has called you to live in. You will have your own testimony in the name of Jesus. Yours will not be an abandoned project, even in the hand of God. Be encouraged. The God of resurrection, the power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, is living inside of you to call what you need into existence. God bless you. May this week be a week of testimony for you in the name of Jesus. I want to hear your testimony. If this word has ministered to you, I want you to make a comment below. Hallelujah. And join me, you know, next week again as I share a little bit of what God has placed in my heart with you. Be encouraged. God bless you. Have a wonderful and awesome week. Shalom. Amen.